In this demonstration, we're showing a use case for Kanzi Connect. Here we've got three tablets. These happen to all be running Android and the same hardware. These could be any devices. This can be hardware from one vendor here, from another vendor here. These can be different operating systems. They could be running on a hypervisor or as independent hardware units connected with any bearer, Wi-Fi or wired. And so with these, right now I have these set up to all be screen one. So this is now in a mirroring situation. When I take this object now and I start moving it around, you can see the mirroring between them. Now if I were to switch to this to display two and I make this display three, in this kind of a logical scenario, I've got three displays, again, could be from different vendors, different hardware platforms, different operating systems. But now I take this object and I flick it to another display. Then I flick it again to the third display. I can bring in other objects. For example, here's a weather object. And similarly, I can flick that from display to display. And now these three independent devices have become one logical user interface. So we've connected these at the UI level. If I now, just for fun, change the theme, the coloring here, now you can see this music object is set up like this. As it's going to play the music, that's how it's visualized. As I flick it across here, now it adopts the theme of the other screen. And similarly here, it goes back to this look and feel. The way this works in practice is we've got a Kanzi Connect server, and we've got Kanzi Connect clients in each of these. So the application itself accesses the client and defines what data it wants to show and what services it wants to bring in. So by separating the server from the clients, you can actually bring any data and any services to any device.